Hi, so let us start our discussion or continue our discussion on cloud computing. As we mentioned that there are several commercial cloud and open source clouds are available providing services at various level like IaaS, PaaS or SaaS. So, one of the popular such cloud we will discuss. So, again the major objective is to just to show you how a commercial cloud works, and so that you can try yourself and see that have the flavor of the cloud, right. So, today we will discuss about Google cloud platform, briefly we will discuss, and we will also give you a short demo how to develop a app or host your a web app into the Google cloud platform, which is very user friendly and easy to use. So, again there is no particular motivation on basically having working with some commercial cloud, but it is just to use it as a use case or test case, so where you can practice and see that how things works. And we are using free account, a demo account, so that you can also try at your end and see that how things works. So, as we understand, Google has a worldwide presence and their data centers are across the globe, and this Google cloud platform also, if you see, they are in various regions, right, like North American region, European region and Asia and so forth. So, they are distributed regions, every region have some zones, and so that these are divided into geographically spread, right. So, there are several services which has a global view, which has a zonal view and more infrastructure wise view. So, keeping all this at the backbone, we will try to see that what Google cloud platform provides. So, if you see like it is a set of services, what they provide is a set of services that enables developers to build, test, deploy application on Google's reliable infrastructure. So, it is we have taken this thing from their web resources, that is their one is cloud.google.com and developers.google.com and related resources. So, what they claim that it is a set of they provide a large set of services that enable developers to build, test, deploy application on Google infrastructure. Google cloud platform is a set of modular cloud based services that allow you to create anything from simple website to complex applications. That means, you can have you can host your website or you can have a complex application running on the cloud. So, if we look at little broad aspect, so it builds, store, analyze. So, this is the three motto, and in order to have, so we have Google have a compute type of services which is provided by Google App Engine, which is primarily a PaaS, and compute engine which provides IaaS type of services. Other than that, it has a storage services, cloud storage, cloud SQL and cloud data store. So, cloud storage services in Google, and there are other services like BigQuery, cloud endpoint type of services. Rather, if you look at their website or the portal, the services are listed there, and they are incremented or increasing or modified over time, right. So, what they claim or what Google try to support is run your application, host your site on Google's infrastructure, build on the same infrastructure that allow Google to return billions of search results in milliseconds. That means, they are basic infrastructure, they serve around 6 billion hours of YouTube video per month and some 425 million Gmail users. So, the same sort of infrastructure you can use when you are using thing. So, it is a globally connected over the network. highly redundant, so it's fault tolerant in that respect. And Google Go On, what they claim that Go On doing innovation, so you have innovative infrastructure in place. So that is what even one use Google platform, what Google wants to provide them. So from the user point of view, they can focus on their application or the product, rapid development, deploy, iterate your applications without worrying about the system administration, etcetera. So all those things are taken care by the back end service provider, in this case Google. Google manages your application, database, storage, servers, so you don't have to. So you don't have to manage all those things. So manage services, right? Developers, tools and SDKs are available, console and administration for management of the thing. So these are the things which are comes with you when we use Google Cloud Platform. So other aspects what they claim or what you can have is mix and match of services. So you have virtual machine, managed platform, blob storage, block storage, NoSQL data store, MySQL databases, big data analytics, cloud, Google Cloud Platform has all the services your application architect needs. So it's a, you can have a number of services if you, and you can have a mix and matches of these services to develop or launch your applications, right? So compute, storage and services are the core of the things, and you can mix and matches of several services to realize the realize your particular application or particular objective of your particular application. So other advantages what they offer is the scale to millions of users. As such, Google has a huge user base, and they have the infrastructure which can support this user base. And as you are using this same infrastructure, as we use this same infrastructure, so we can basically scale to these millions of users. So applications hosted in cloud platform can automatically scale up to handle most demanding workloads and scale down when the traffic is subdued. So scale up, scale down is both possible. So you pay only you use, right? Pay as you go model. Scale up, cloud platform is designed to scale like Google's own products, right? Like if you use Google other products, so whenever the demand is high, it scale up and so forth. Right. Even when you experience a huge traffic spike, then it actually what they propose or what they offer is that the type of things they are doing with their own products, that same type of support or management they do for the when you somebody launches something on the Google Cloud Platform. So manage services such as Google App Engine or cloud data store give you auto scaling that enables your application grow with your users. So these are the managed services like GAE, Google App Engine or cloud data store, which provides auto scaling. Whenever the load is higher, it goes up or other way around. Scale down, just as cloud platform allows you to scale up, managed services also scale down. Right, you don't pay for computing resources, you don't. So if you have lesser load, so you can scale down, so that release of the or deactivating the computing resources are in place. So also claim that or we can have a good performance or good return on our investment or hiring this Google Cloud Platform. So Google's compute infrastructure give you consistent CPU, memory and disk performance. So that is that they guarantee. The network and edge cache serve responses rapidly to your users across the world. So if you are a business user or you have in turn that user across the world, so they also get the advantages of Google's scale up and type of services, right? So it can be in terms of CPU, memory, disk. It can be in terms of the network, global network. It can be maybe in transparent maintenance of the infrastructure or your application. And also you get support you need with a worldwide community users, partner ecosystem and premium support packages. Google provides full range of resources to help you to get started and grow. So, that means the Google overall support come into play whenever you launch in the Google Cloud platform. So, these are more what we say means advantages what Google claim they provide, and it is if these are available to the to a customer or a user, so it is the headache of maintenance, manageability, etcetera is reduced to a large extent, and you pay for the services you use and type of things. So, if we look at the Google Cloud platform, so compute services, one is compute engine, another is a app engine, one is primarily IaaS type of things, another is a PaaS type of stuff. So, cloud platform offers both a full managed platform, fixed flexibility, flexible virtual machine allow you to choose a system that you need to that you need. So, that well a Google cloud platform, it has a both a managed platform and a flexible machine. So, that means you can have a flexibility configuring reconfiguring a VM, use app engine or PaaS type of services when you just want to focus on your code and not worry about the patching or maintenance etcetera, not about the infrastructure. So, you require a development platform to develop and get access to raw virtual machine with compute engine and have flexibility to build anything you think. So, other than you can have your own VM and then you have a flexibility of loading apps or other type of things on that virtual machine and have a IaaS type of services out of it. Secondly, another vertical is storage. So, it provides variety of options. One is cloud storage, cloud SQL, cloud data store, persistent disk. So, these are the different things which are offered by GCP or the Google Cloud platform. It provides a range of storage services that allow you to maintain an easy quick access to your data, right. So, it is a range of storage services. With cloud SQL and data store, you get MySQL and NoSQL databases, while cloud storage provides flexible object storage with global edge things. So, for with data store and SQL or SQL and data store, you get the MySQL type of things and another type of NoSQL type of databases. So, this is more of a database related service, where cloud storage provide object storage with global edge caching. That means, you can basically store and access across the globe. And finally, there are several app services which is like BigQuery, cloud endpoints, caching and queues. So, these are app services, right. With Google APIs and services to quickly, you can use Google API or services to quickly enable a wide range of functionality for your application, right. So, you can build your application using this app services. One need not build this from scratch, just take advantage of easy integration of Google platform. So, that is the app engine tries to give. So, it is a bunch of APIs which are which can be leveraged for your own developing your own application, right. So, this is a quick brief overview of what are the different modules and verticals of Google is. So, it if you want more details, you can basically go to their website and check that more how things works. This just is to show that these are the different verticals, but as I mentioned at the beginning of that thing, that our objective is to show some example cases on some commercial and open source cloud, so that you can try yourself and see that how things works, right, and what are the nitty gritty of the things, right. So, like here also we will show two applications, two example cases now. Right. So before that, so if you look at the whole thing, like cloud platform services from the user end, considered to migrate your application to Google Cloud Platform for better performance using Google App Engine, where you can migrate your application, web application, to cloud platform, or your application should go wherever your users grow, like scale your application using Google Cloud Endpoints, and integrate Google services into your application using APIs, right. So, if you can integrate Google services in your applications, which may be running locally or in cloud, and using Google APIs. So, Google App Engine, Google Endpoints, Google APIs are some of the things which plays an important role. And as we were discussing, we'll show two example scenario with this Google Cloud Platform or GCP, which to demonstrate that how a typical cloud works, right? You can try yourself and have more complex examples. So, these are two simple examples. One is to host your web page in the Google Cloud Platform, that is already you are having a web page designed locally, and you want to upload and host the web pages into Google Cloud Platform, Google Cloud Platform or GCP, and use their storages for that. And the second one is building web application using Google App Engine. So, we will use this Google App Engine services to build a web application. So, two simple applications, but I believe that it will help you to, especially those who are new to this cloud thing, to help you in developing small application and have a hands-on experience with the commercial cloud. Fine. So, we'll continue with the application, and for this with me Shreya will join. She will show you how a Google Google web page can be hosted, or a web page can be built using Google App Engine.